evil eye, you understand me. Walk her down the valley, pack a piece of heaven for the bottoms of her feet. Teach her how to jump and how to stretch when she reach, like the angels do, and you gon' make it through now. Tell about the healer, greater is the one within, and call him as the leader.
There is no one above you, no one beside you, nobody like you. There will be no other God before you. Good
morning, welcome to a new vlog. It is a Monday morning. I took a break yesterday because it was a really busy day, but I'm out. I already did a client this morning. I was up so early, and now I'm going to the cafe to do some work. It's Monday, so today's not my rest day. We're going to find another day to do rest day. But you guys know I believe in at least resting one day of the week. So we have some travel to do tomorrow, like a road trip. So it's going to be a good week. In Jesus' name, this is the day that the Lord has made me really rejoice and be glad in it. God, we send you ahead of us this week on this Monday morning. We ask that you clear the way, make a way where there seems to be no way. Allow favor to go before us, goodness, mercy, grace to go before us. And just allow all of our efforts to be successful this week in Jesus' name. I need to start off each week with a prayer. What do you guys think? I don't know, but I just feel like praying this morning. Anyway, I feel good. I have some planning to do. I'm going to let you guys know what it is we're doing soon, but I'm going to plan it out right now. In the cafe, I have a next client in this area, so that's why I decided to come to the cafe and do some work, and then we're going to keep it going. Bye. I'll see you guys soon. I need to stop saying bye because then I come back, but yeah, bye.
Guys, isn't this cafe just so beautiful though? It is just so pretty.
Spinning through identity, reveal another pretty little scheme. Save her mind, hold her hand, and don't believe a lie, you understand me. Walk her down the valley, pack a piece of heaven for the bottoms of her feet. Teach her how to jump and how to stretch when she reach, like the angels do, and you gon' make it through now. Tell about the healer, greater is the one within, and call him as the leader. Teach her how to hold a pretty hand up to the sky, and have a weight upon the giver, he'll deliver like a dealer.
To take her higher.
Guys, I'm home, and I'm on the floor because I don't want to sit on the bed with my out clothes. But I'm going to eat some combi fun rice that I cooked, and try to like edit and post stuff and do stuff that I have to do. So that's what I'm going to do. Just wanted to check in and tell you guys that I'm home. Look how greasy. But I love my face to glow though. I don't like a dry face. Like, I like a dry face because I know that I'm going to start a glow in like 3 hours. So that's my technique to my method to the madness.
This is my gym fit for today. I'm in desperate need of gym clothes. So this is what I'm wearing.
Guys, I am just home from the gym and I'm about to pack my kit because I have to travel to my friend. She's doing a photo shoot and I'm about to do the makeup for her. JT Witty, you guys know JT Witty. That's my baby. So I'm about to pack my kit. Then I have a client, so I have to go to my client. She's like 45 minutes away. And then, yeah. So it's all good.
Train her feet for running. Show her every door and how the windows let the sun in. Copy out the key and tell her this is for becoming. Even in the fever.
This lady, she has been yelling at people all evening. All evening, she has been yelling. Yelling at people. I love it. She loves her job. She loves her job so much.
guys, I am on the bus. But usually they give out free waters, but they didn't do that today, so I'm gonna get a water. Cause I have a little bit of water here, but I don't think I might get anywhere with this. I think I might need a little bit more because it's like 4 hours. I need water.
Okay, I'm about to get a water because that water I would not survive. I promised myself not to buy any candy too. Hello guys. Hi, how are y'all doing? Nice. Water. Where are you, water? Oh Lord. We get this one. I look so I am at my destination. I'm at my destination and I see the most beautiful Christmas tree. It is so pretty. Isn't it so pretty? So I'm getting an Uber and I'm gonna be off. I was sleeping in the bus and I'm trying to fix my wig. You know, after all, it is a wig. So my Uber is like 7 minutes away. So that's good. What are you doing up here? Okay. Bye. We found Jada, guys. Guys, do you see how fancy this is? Wow. Okay, girl. I love the bathroom decor. Fly about the valley
in the fire. Train her feet for running. Show her every door and how the windows let the sun in. Copy out the key and tell her this is for becoming. Even in the fever, baby, cry and get to running. And tell her that you better get your bootstraps up. You're with the army. Ready when the truth act up, nothing can harm me. Yelling from the roof I touch, put up a guarding. Count to 10, lion's den, speaking with the higher pen. Can't be touched by fire then. Fast forward to the grown things now. I'm working on them soul things now. Forgiving all your old ways.
Good morning, guys. This is my little look for today. I know it's so pretty. I need to take out this chain, right, Jay?
I didn't see. Let me see.
Let me go see if I need to take out the chain.
Do I need like a smaller earring? Or is this good?
Okay, guys. So I changed my earrings. Do you see? These are nice and cute because I'm gonna be working, so I needed to be very comfortable. I want this cute hat, this onesie that I always wear. I don't have to zip it down. I have to. I think put it up because it's cold outside. I'm about to be freezing. What's the temperature? I have no idea. Like 42 or something. Anyway, I think I look super cute and I love it. Today's gonna be a legit period. Today's gonna be a good day. I'm so excited.
Yeah.
Good vibes, good energy only. I'm gonna try to give you guys like a little sneak peek of like me doing the makeup. I have on this Fenty lipstick, lip gloss, and MAC lip liner, and I think it's really cute. I did my makeup with my work kit, so I didn't have any of my personal products, but we made a rig. I didn't even put any primer. Yeah, I put on primer today. It's Fenty soft matte, but yeah, so let's go. Good morning.
Space, guys. She looks amazing.
Oh, she is just something else, guys. She is something else. I'm gonna clean up my area because I have another girl to do, but they're gonna be quick. Jada was like a little beat, but everybody else wants to be real quick. Let me show you guys body yaddy yaddy. Okay, body yaddy yaddy.
My girl, she's renting on suites, and this is how pretty it is over here. It is so nice. She has a little painting. This is a suite here.
No windows though, but this is a suite here.
This is a suite here. This one has a window, which is nice. And then there is more over there. But isn't it so pretty? Then there's this big mirror. It's so nice.
OT is here making it happen for Jada.
He's so proud of me. I need to stop calling her my baby because she's a grown up now. So that's my little sister.
Okay.
So you don't know to fix the hair, make sure it flips.
I need to take this off first. Okay, I'm about to.
I'm on it. You guys see her hair? Whoa, give them the view.
Yeah,
really good, girl. Alright, that I have to do for now. Let me bring gloss and everything over there to make sure everybody is glossed well. Lipstick, gloss. I'm carrying my lipstick, my gloss. To make sure the girls are Gucci. Over there, I'm carrying my powders. I don't know, lipsticks and gloss for now. I'm carrying my. I have no idea. Let's just go with lipsticks and gloss. I feel like I should carry my powder, you know, like an average color powder. Here we go. Let's go. Is somebody?
Yeah, and y'all want to sit, but which one? Like y'all knees kind of want to like face each other. Perfect. You. All right, come on there, and you want to sit on that back, and you want to have your leg up on the couch. So sit sideways.
What's that one?
Let's go with the yeah. That side right there.
She wanna get the music.
And the hair.
Guys, we're having food finally. This is from Panda. Somebody. Panda Express. What you got in our red box? Oh, what is it? Mushroom?
Steak.
Steak, okay. Today was so amazing. We are finished. Jada did amazing. We are both grateful for how the day went.
We are very grateful.
Good alright.
Now, okay guys, I am now going back home. Well, my taco toast up and I'm having an ice cream cone because that's what I fell for. And I'll have a salad maybe later, but ice cream cone for now. Ice cream cone for now. Have my bags here and my bag here. I parked my car at my client's house, so I have to drive. I have to go really far then drive home for like 45 minutes, which is not bad, but all in all, to God be the glory, everything happened. My friend photo shoot was really good. I'm happy I was able to show up for her because she would always show up for me, and I'm just super duper duper grateful. So I'm back on my way to home to carry on in my life. I'm waiting on the bus. It's like a bit of a long drive, but I love sitting on the bus. I love being on the bus so much, you have no idea. I'm posting on TikTok too, so good morning. We're on the bus, or we're waiting on the bus.
I am dancing because I'm finally home. I didn't vlog much today because I was traveling, and this week has just been busy, but I'm so proud that
fast forward to the grown things now. I'm working on them soul things now, forgiving all your old ways, but it's harder on the cold days.
Cold days.
Never been a product of a flawless environment. Never acted like I'm higher than you.
My devotion, and I'm reading John 11. I'm actually listening to it. Alexa, stop. Which I actually enjoy listening to it.
The raising of Lazarus.
So I would listen to it and then read from here. He lived in Bethany, which is so good for me. Hey guys, this is my gym fit today. You see, the stomach is going down. I wish I could have before and after pictures for y'all, but this went down so much. Way better. I look like I'm going to rob a drugstore. I put on some earrings and a chain. Call it a day.
I would rather be running. Dear God, won't you send me a break? Cause I need to get away.
Good morning! I am now finished working out and it was good. I got up this morning, I did my breakfast as you guys saw. I did devotion. Did I show you guys my breakfast? I'm not sure, but I did devotion and I did a workout. I should have showed you guys my breakfast. Not sure if I did. I used my phone to like go on YouTube and do the workout, so I couldn't really like, you know, tape. And today's about to be a good day. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Today's the rest day two. Like I rest day started from yesterday because I was like I didn't have a rest day this week, but I kind of did not work yesterday, so I'm gonna. But I have work later at 2 p.m. So I'm gonna relax this morning, make some porridge. What do I like to do on rest day? Do I have any time to lay down at all? I have to go to a Christmas concert at church today. I have to reach with my client for one. So I have to clean my kit. So I need at least an hour to get ready. So I need to be out of the house by 1:30. For two, I need to reach with my client. So I have to be out of the house by 1:30. And it's 10:30 now. 11:30, 12:30, 1. So I have 3 hours. I have no time to lay down. I'm going to go home, pack, organize my kit, make some porridge, take a shower and gather myself.
To wear something more churchy, but this is what I have. This is what we're gonna do. I just have on this sneakers to match, and yeah, it's a vibe. Go with this bag with it just to make it fun and cute. I'm gonna have this bag with it, and this is gonna be my outfit for today.
There's no temptation that is bigger.
Hello.
So for it to have come, and
I am about to do my friend's makeup. She has a gala to go to. I'm just in the car listening to Joshua Selman. You know I love Joshua Selman, and it just happened to come up on the TV. And let me put my thing here because I want to talk to you guys about the message that he was talking about. So basically he was speaking about how What was he talking about? He was talking about how just like accomplishing the purpose that God has for your life and some of the things that has hold us back. And what I got from it is that you have to be able to surrender to the will of God for your life. Right? He was saying that a lot of people, they don't rise, even Christian people. They're going to pray, they're going to fast, they're going to do so many things. But unless you surrender to the will of God for your life and what you've been called to do, it don't make no sense. Then God can't use you. You have to be able to be willing to walk in the will of God and where He's calling you to be able to be used by God, right? And usually the will of God for your life is really to, like, in whatever you do, for His name to be made great, for Jesus to be glorified. And it's coming back to a scripture that I was looking at last week in John 3, I think 25, and it says, my desire is not that I will glorify myself, but that the Lord will glorify me. You understand? So it's kind of like we have to surrender and say, Lord, you glorify me. Let your will be done in my life. Order my steps. You know what? Like, you have to surrender. And I know that's sometimes hard to do because, you know, we have the fear of, you know, is God really good? Would He really do good things in my life? So then we move around feeling like we can make better decisions, and you have to do this and we have to do this to make sure everything goes okay. And we carry the, you know, the weight of the world on our shoulders, when in truth and in fact, the solution is just to surrender and say, Lord, that scripture, that John 3:25 or something, it says, it's not my will to glorify myself. That's when Jesus was going through and He was doing miracles. And they were telling Him, you know, if you're the Son of God, do this and do that. He said, I don't want to glorify myself. The Lord will glorify me. And we have to come to a point where we say, God, my plans to glorify myself, to promote myself, to make my life better, cannot even fathom the way that you would do it. So I surrender to the way that you want to do it, to your will. And then from the time you surrender, you give God full authority to use you for His honor and His glory. And that's His plan for our life, right? And then He was saying too that the second thing is obedience. You have to be obedient to the Holy Spirit. In the small things, in the big things, you really have to be obedient. And when I think about surrender and obedience, they work hand in hand. Because to be obedient to God and to even hear Him, what He's telling you to be obedient to, you have to be in a place of surrender, right? To even hear Him, to even obey Him, right? So the two of them can work without each other. And then He went on to the third point, which is worship, and how important it is to just worship God. Like, it's unexplainable what worship is able to do. Men is still not able to really explain the power of worship, but it's so powerful. And how not just singing because He's a worshiper, but just exalting His name with words. And how worship is something that's come from your heart and it's affect your spirit and your brain and your mind and your soul. And then the last point, which I was listening to and I just stopped, was sacrifice. You have to be willing to sacrifice. And not even be willing, but just be. I feel like once you surrender to God and His will, that is like a sacrificial place. You know, you say, God, I surrender my will for your life. So, for your will for my life. So basically, like, you're sacrificing your wants, your desires, and how you think things should be for His own. So all of them kind of works hand in hand. Because the thing with worship is it will take you through. It will increase your faith. It will take you from glory to glory. When you're feeling down, it's a pick me up. So, like, worship is like the gas that has drive the car. You understand what I mean? And like, the will of God is the car. And the worship is the thing that fuel in your faith and everything that drive in the car, which is the will of God. Right? And now you surrendering to the will of God is like saying, God, wherever you go, I will go. Wherever you go, I will go. Right? Wherever you want this car to go, I will go. And it's just so beautiful. And then the obedience is hearing, okay, I'm going to go where you want to go. You understand? So it's just like a whole big thing. And it's like, we really just, the point of the matter, the fact is surrender. We have to be able to give up our will. But you know, it's hard to give up your will when you don't understand that God is good. Right? That God is good. Giving up your will has a lot to do with remembering that God is good indeed. I feel like it starts with knowing that He is good and He wants good things for your life. Like, my Zoom is not even working. I came to edit. I'm sure I pressed something wrong. and I forgot the cord that connects from the camera to the computer to edit. So now I cannot edit. I want to create some policies so when people book in, so like when they book in, they can just read this and have all of the information, like the deposit is non-refundable, we have classes available. So with everybody who have an inquiry, I would tell them, hey, this is what you have to do to book, you know. Then I send it out to them. So it's because I had a whole refund thing with a girl, like, and I was like, I don't give a refund. She's like, I didn't teach in any policy. So I'm creating a policy for these people because I'm not gonna do it. You feel me? So I'm just trying to get some Wi-Fi at Starbucks right now. I was shooting in the wrong mode, which is weird. But I'm just gonna put this to charge. At the Starbucks, I'm just trying to get some Wi-Fi. Let me see if Canva would come up. Yes. I brought the wrong thing to work with. Let's taste this coffee for real. Christmas concert at church. It was so nice. So Yvette and I are gonna get some late night Caribbean food by this place. This time I'm going to go to this place, so I'm excited to see what they have. It's kind of like a Savannah in a shop. They close like 4 a.m so that's like super duper good. I'm just gonna follow her because she's better at driving through these streets. I make way, but I do a lot of unnecessary turns that I don't need to do to get where I need to get to. So that's me. But what is that smoking behind me? Is that Yvette's car smoking? Yeah, so let's go. I love this red jacket I wore today. This is gonna be my Christmas jacket. I'm gonna wear it in December and January. All winter I'm gonna wear it. It's okay.
Good morning, y'all. I am here and guess what I'm doing? I'm making, you guys already know, cornmeal porridge. Oh god, oh I'm making cornmeal porridge, which is like super duper duper good. I put a little bit of cornmeal so it cooks real nice. It's cooking real good. Now I'm just gonna mix the milk mixture that I do. What I do is I just mix this with a little bit of raw soup. And that does it.
This Saturday morning, I feel like oil is in my eye. And I haven't edited not even one piece of this vlog, of this week's vlog. So it all has to happen between 10:30 and 2:30. So like 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30. Yeah, that's 4 hours I have. So let's go in and make it happen. I need to poop. What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? Oh my god. What? Making me stronger, yeah, yeah. Crisis in my life, oh yeah, I'm good, yeah. Crisis in my life, oh yeah, I'm good, yeah, yeah. I'm good, I'm good, I'm good. I just found this Jamaican vegan spot and they have mac and cheese, vegan mac and cheese, teriyaki broccoli, plantains. So let's try it.
So let's try it. The mac and cheese is vegan.
It's
good. Wow.
The food is so good. I just got the orange juice, freshly squeezed orange juice. It's $8, which I think is a lot of money, but good food cost. So I spend way more money on bad food.